Now, the story we first told you about at the top of our newscast, the man caring for Elizabeth Thomas, her brother James, is accused of raping an inmate. Two women are making the accusations, including James Thomas's former co-worker, who says he admitted committing a crime. Once Chief Investigative Reporter Jeremy Finley started asking questions, the Maury County DA launched an investigation.
Elizabeth Thomas has not been seen in more than 5 days.
That leaves a big hole in my heart that you've been taken away from us.
For a community shaken by the kidnapping of Elizabeth Thomas, it was welcome news that she was now safe under the care of her older brother James, a longtime correctional officer in the county jail. But for these two women, the news of who was now Elizabeth's custodian is chilling.
He is a sexual predator.
Should he be caring for this girl?
No, he shouldn't care for anyone.
This former co-worker of James Thomas, herself once a correctional officer, has now sent this letter to the district attorney claiming he raped an inmate.
He said, I would go to the federal penitentiary for what I've done. I observed video.
You've seen video of him going into her cell?
Yes. There is no doubt in my mind that there was a sexual relationship happening.
Claims strongly disputed by Thomas's attorney.
In no uncertain terms, he absolutely denies that there was ever, once, ever any physical contact between him and this woman while she was in jail. Period.
I'd wake up and he'd be standing there in the middle of our cell, 2 o'clock in the morning.
Former inmate Carissa Christ says Thomas raped her several times, but she says she never said anything.
When it's an inmate's word against an officer, the inmate's always wrong.
She says she was raped.
And she was, because she was an inmate. There's no such thing as consensual sex inside a jail facility.
This former co-worker of James Thomas says to this day she's never discussed the rape claims with Christ. She says she only heard of it from Thomas himself.
Why else would you make the statement that you could land in the federal penitentiary for what you've done?
How can two women who have never discussed this with each other both say that he committed this crime?
I can't speak to what their motives are. Just like I can't speak to why this is coming up now, allegedly 2 years after the fact.
I went and reported it.
But the former coworker says she didn't wait 2 years to report it, that she told her supervisor and wrote detailed incident reports on how often Thomas was entering Christ's cell. The sheriff's office wouldn't do an interview because of the DA investigation, but says they can find no evidence of incident reports or anything noted in the computer system of Thomas going into Christ's cell. But they did provide this, a complaint written from another female inmate in 2016, saying she witnessed Thomas in Christ's cell and inappropriate conversation. And Christ herself responded, writing, "None of that is true. We asked her about that." Her response, she was told the complaint was about another correctional officer coming into her cell, not Thomas. Thomas's attorney says he's done nothing wrong and is capable of caring for his sister.
I would not be representing James Thomas even now if I believe that there is one shred of truth to these allegations.
These women disagree.
Do you have concerns for Elizabeth Thomas?
Of course I do. I mean, it gives me chills.
Let's be very clear. These two women say they have no proof of James Thomas harming his sister at all. The sheriff's office says as for claims of Thomas repeatedly going into that cell, they don't keep video that far back in order to check. The TBI confirms when the former co-worker contacted them, they alerted the DA, and the DA is now trying to interview everyone involved. We've got a lot more on the story right now on the WSMV app, and we'll keep investigating. Jeremy Finley, the News 4 I team.